Good morning. I am on my way to Sister's Coffee Company, I think it's called, to get breakfast and some coffee. Then I'm gonna go to the grocery store and get the supplies I need to survive today. Oh, just a second. This is my first 0 day since Shasta. So that's a few hundred miles away. The last, yeah, that was just a Nero in when I got to, what was that town that I did not like? I forgot it, with the Morning Glory Cafe. Ashland. I got in there early and was supposed to just relax, but I ended up walking a million miles back and forth and blah blah blah. That was a noisy car. But this is a very small town, so should be able to get a lot done. Yeah. Well, blah 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 blah. I will go get my breakfast and I will see you guys later. It is just before 7 o'clock, so town hasn't really woken up yet, but there was some years back the decision to make this town look cowboy-y, so every building has to have like this cowboy feel to it, which they have done very nicely. It's it's quite cool actually. Yeehaw! I just left Sister's Coffee Company. It is an amazing place. Nice atmosphere. Delicious coffee. Wow. First real latte on the trail, I think. It is. Yes. And it was good. The breakfast burrito was awesome. Very delicious. And they have good Wi-Fi, so go there. While me and Lost Boy, who I met last night, he was camping at the campgrounds as well, and he told me that I should go to Three Sisters, or to Sisters Coffee Company. So I met him there this morning, and while we were sitting, eating our breakfast burrito and drinking coffee, this woman came over, and she said she could spot a thru-hiker a mile away and offered to give us a ride. Lost Boy already had a ride and I needed one tomorrow, and she offered to drive me to the trail just like that. It's simply amazing. So cool. Kindness of strangers. So she's gonna pick me up at the coffee house tomorrow at 10 and drive me to the trail, which is just amazing. Right now I am on my way to the grocery store. I think I picked the one farthest away for some reason, but that's just me in a nutshell. I'm gonna buy the supplies I need to survive today and worry about resupplies tomorrow instead. before I get picked up. I think I might need to check my maps now, just to make sure I'm on the right path. Okay, so. I am back on the trail. The wonderful lady from yesterday, Blanche, who offered to give me a ride out here, just dropped me off, and I am about to do a dry section with no shade at all. And today is supposed to be one of the hottest days of the year, 100 plus degrees, which is rarely seen in Sisters. So I hope I will survive. And I did get a bunch of videos edited, uploaded and ready, but you have already seen those when I show this video. I got the hole in my sleeping pad. I got that patched. I got a shower yesterday. So everything is good, and I am now ready to rumble. No, I'm ready to go. Cool. In my plan today is to do 20 miles. 20, hopefully 25. And be in a government camp in 4 days. So I will just get going. I got the hole in my sleeping pad. I got that patched. I got a shower yesterday. So everything is good, and I am now ready to rumble. No, I'm ready to go. Cool. In my plan today is to do 20 miles. 20, hopefully 25. And be in a government camp in 4 days. So I will just get going. That is Belknap Crater and Little Belknap. Supposedly all the lava rock you see around, and I've shown in the previous videos and everything, comes from Belknap Crater. So that has been one hell of an active volcano once upon a time. It's kind of crazy. And it is, it's starting to get very hot. Not because I'm close to the crater or anything, but the lava rocks, they just suck up heat. And it's almost noon, so yeah. Stupid time to be hiking, but apparently I will never learn. It is almost 3 o'clock and I have only done about 11.3 miles, I think, up to that sign. So I'm not making 25 miles today, that is for sure. But we'll see. I can make a few more miles, and then I'll just have to push a little bit harder for the next few days. Maybe start a little bit earlier than I usually do and see if we can't keep it on schedule anyway. Yeah, so I will go to Big Lake Youth Camp right now. I am at the Big Lake, Big Lake Youth Camp. That's a hard one. Just waiting for dinner. They serve dinner at 6:10. I got here a few hours, 2 hours ago maybe, I think. Just been hanging out. It seems like a very nice place. I'm gonna eat dinner and then I will head out at about 7 o'clock. Just do, I don't know, 5 miles or so to a campground, just to be away, because else I will just stay here, do breakfast in the morning, and yeah, time flies. And I still want to be in government camp in 4 days, including today, so I have some big mile days ahead of me. Yeah, but right now just relaxing. It's been a tough day, 12 miles or so, so I think I can manage. Oh yeah, well, it's good, it's good. That was some nice noodles. I haven't had noodles in a long time. No, it was good. That was vegetables. Okay. Those healthy things that grow in the ground and everything. Vegetables. I am now gonna pack up my stuff and head out on the trail and enjoy the sunset while I'm hiking a few miles. My initial plan after leaving Big Lake Youth Camp was to do about 5-ish miles. That would get me to camp at around 8 o'clock, just about. But it seems, well, according to Godhooks, the next campsite is 8 miles away. I think that's probably too late. I know I don't have to eat dinner because I already ate dinner, so I can just set up my tent and go to sleep. But yeah, I don't know. I have to see how I feel at 8 o'clock. Might do it, might not do it. But yeah, I could also just find a camp spot at 8 o'clock, go to bed, get some rests, and then get up in the morning when the alarm starts at 5, and get some miles in. It's supposed to be very hot tomorrow, 100 plus, so it might be good to get the first 10-15 miles in before the sun really kicks in. I want to do at least 30 miles tomorrow. So I gotta catch up on the slacking I've been doing today. I wasn't supposed to go into Big Lake Youth Camp, and it's a nice place. I give them that, but I could live without. It's not one of the places that you just have to visit. But if you happen to get there after a long day, it's pretty nice. So yeah, if it fits into your schedule, go there. They're nice people, and the food is free, which is it's just amazing. So thank you so much for that, Big Lake Youth Camp. Nice. Okay, I will hike on, and even though I have the sunset behind me, as you can see, the colors are starting to get really nice on the trees and on the trail, so I will enjoy that. What? 2,000 miles? That's crazy. So 600 something miles left. Wow. Yeah. Wow. That is 2,000 miles. That's insane. Simply insane. Wow. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I'm probably gonna say same thing when I hit 2,100 miles and so on and so on, but it just mosquitoes. It's just I just feel like I did 900 miles and now it's already 2,000 miles. It's going fast. Oh yeah. Crazy. It is 9 o'clock. I made it to camp, and as you can see, it's dark. I decided I wanted some hot chocolate, so I am boiling some water. That's gonna make me sleep nice and cozy. Yeah, tomorrow I will have a long day, so yeah. So I will see you tomorrow. Today I, well, 13, I think I made it about 15 miles ish. So it's been a very easy day today, I must say. But that's how it is. I'll make up for it tomorrow. So see you guys tomorrow.